And that's your latest weather.
All right, Al, thank you very much. Today's American story with Bob Dotson comes from Syracuse, New York, home to a man who's given thousands of people a second chance at life. Bob, happy holidays. Merry Christmas. Good to have you here.
Merry Christmas. It's great to be here. The ghost of Christmas past. You know, some of the longest living heart patients are waking up this morning, and they are relishing the fact that they are alive. You won't believe what one of them has done with all those years.
In medicine and in life, your most valuable possession is an open heart. George Heitzman has touched a lot of hearts in his 91 years. Not like an artist or a poet, like a pioneer.
Well, I don't look at myself as a pioneer. I started something and I was taught to finish it.
He was a chest surgeon at the dawn of open heart surgery, back when few expected patients would live full lives. But Susan Pingleton has lived longer than most. She owes her life to what George Heitzman learned from a dog. Back in 1957, surgeons first tried out new procedures on animals, chilling their hearts, doing the operation and then quickly reviving them. But one of those hearts started beating erratically.
We call it ventricular fibrillation. It's lethal unless it's treated very quickly.
Dr. Heitzman wrapped his hands around the dog's heart and started massaging. Half hour went by. Some in the operating room figured he'd quit, but not the surgeon. He kept pumping that dog's heart until the dog survived.
The idea was you don't give up. You keep working until you get things corrected.
A few weeks later, Susan Pingleton was in the operating room. Suddenly, her heart began to quiver like the dog's.
Dr. Heitzman didn't just operate on your heart. He fought for it.
For over an hour.
An hour and 18 minutes later, Susan's heart began to beat regularly again. But Dr. Heitzman was still concerned. He said what no parent wants to hear.
He warned them that I might be brain dead.
When you opened your eyes.
I opened my eyes and saw my parents and said, hello. Big moment.
But then she tried to walk.
My legs were weak and I took about two steps and I fell.
The operation had damaged her spinal cord.
And so I had to stay in the hospital for 3-4 months, and I couldn't walk after my surgery.
Lying in that hospital bed, she recalled Dr. Heitzman's battle for her life and its lesson.
You don't give up. Whatever you need to do, you do.
3 months later, Susan walked on those weak legs.
Yes.
Eventually, they would carry her back to the hospital, this time as a doctor teaching other doctors. The associate dean of Kansas University Medical School.
You're the generational learner that we need to appeal
to.
George Heitzman is never far from her heart.
He gave me life. I literally and figuratively would not be here without him.
Not everybody would massage a heart until their hands went numb. What inspired you to keep going?
I think my mother had a great deal to do with it.
A nurse who urged both her boys to become doctors. They did.
We thought of nothing else, and I have no regrets.
Neither does Susan Pingleton, who received his heartfelt gift.
Dr. Heitzman can relate to the joy she feels. The man who inserted the first pacemaker into a heart in Syracuse, New York, now has one too.
Incredible story.
Wow.
A beautiful story.
That's a Christmas.
That is what Christmas is all about, Bob. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Bob.
And coming up, one of the stars of Sochi, U.S. champion figure skater Gracie Gold. And then up next, a dinner serve, a simple meal from start to finish that you still have time to prepare today. But first, this is Today on NBC.